That was really nice with the music. And 10 years ago, I was here in Ahmedabad at the National Institute of Design. And I had taken up a project to redesign a bedpan at VS Hospital. Now, my main motivation for doing that project was because I thought people deserved better. More comfort, more hygiene, better dignity. So one concept that I came to understand very deeply during this time was that of constraints. So solutions that perform, technology solutions, services that perform in advanced healthcare settings do not perform in resource-constrained settings. They are the advanced healthcare settings such as the high-end hospitals, the Apollos and the Fortises that we know so well. Why is that? So this is a video, if it plays, from a government-run child development clinic. As you can see, there are too many people accessing the facility. There's too much noise. You would know if I turned the volume on, but then you couldn't have heard me. You can imagine just how stressed a baby is under these conditions. There are not enough skilled healthcare workers, obviously, and prohibitive costs. Most developing countries, you will agree, have similar situations. So how can we create context-specific innovation and appropriate technology? How can we put innovation in the hands of masses so it can improve their quality of life? These are some of the questions that we are answering at Sohum Innovation Lab. I co-founded the company 2 years ago. Sohum, it's actually from the Vedanta. In Sanskrit, it means, I am that. Some say that when a child comes into the world, it asks, Koham, Koham, who am I? That is what it is crying. So at that time, the universe replies, Soham, you are the same as I am. In fact, because it's a natural way to control one's breathing pattern, even if you just utter the word, the name of our company, you're supposed to become healthier. So we design medical devices. We're in the area of health. And one of the projects that we're working on is to screen infants for hearing loss. Now, something that hasn't changed in the last 10 years since I did my first product in the medical field is this idea, this context of resource constraints. Let's talk about hearing. We just heard a lot of music right now, and I'm sure everybody enjoyed that. Can you all hear me? Yes. Great. So there are 4 million children in the age group of 0 to 15 in India today who cannot hear. They were not screened at the right time. They have lost their speech. And they may never catch up, even with the best of rehabilitation. Hearing, in the first 6 months of life, as soon as you're born, is crucial for normal acquisition of language, of communication. So it is no wonder, then, that most developed countries have a universal hearing screening program, which screens every child for hearing loss as soon as she's born, irrespective of where she's born, within the first 6 months. In India, this does not exist. Now, this is an irony, because 90% of all children that are born with hearing loss are born in developing countries, like India. This is because of jaundice, measles, rubella, ototoxicity, birth trauma, and a whole of other problems. So let's talk about the current situation. A child is born. This is a time for great happiness and joy. Then comes growth and development. The child becomes 1 year old. She crawls, she walks, she develops motor skills. She becomes 2 years old. Then her parents realize she is not talking yet. So they ask around. So the family, the grandparents, they say, "Are even you are late to talk. It's only a matter of time." The child is 3 years old or older. They go to a nearby general physician who actually sends them to a pediatrician who lives several kilometers away. They go to this pediatrician. The pediatrician, she refers them to an ENT specialist who is in a nearby town. Now, by this time, the parents are very anxious. They have gone through a lot of steps and a lot of frustration already. They go to an ENT specialist who is expensive. He prescribes tests that are even more additionally expensive. And at this point, if they do get access to the right device and someone trained to use it, the child finally gets diagnosed with hearing loss. By then, she's already having developmental delays. She has lost her speech. She may never catch up with her hearing peers, even with the best of rehabilitation. She may never have equal access to education to employment. Now, all of this could have been prevented if she'd been screened at the right time as soon as she was born. So why is universal hearing screening not happening in India today? This is because solutions from advanced healthcare systems cannot be exported directly for use here. Some of these devices do not work in noisy environments. They need a soundproof room, which is not always practical to build. Some of them need someone with extreme skills to be able to use the test. And such a person is not always present in rural India or among the urban poor. Some of these demand the use of expensive disposable electrodes. And some of them need a lot of time, which is just not available. Now, in short, they don't perform in constraints. So we decided to stop freaking out about the constraints. We decided instead to embrace them. We let these constraints guide us, and with that came an unmatched opportunity for innovation, invention, and creativity. We made a device that overcomes all these obstacles to enable mass screening. So we use a technology called ABR, which is auditory evoked brainstem response. What it does is it reads the electrophysiological responses or the brain signals of an infant to check if she can hear or not. Sounds complicated, it's really easy to use. Anybody from the audience could get up and just use it right now. We have hardware and software that performs in noisy environments, such as those that exist in crowded maternity homes or the clinics of general physicians, where currently there are no such devices. We have unique algorithms that cancel noise. We don't need expensive disposable electrodes, which means now the test becomes extremely affordable to anybody from any family. So think of it as being comparable to a basic blood test. The electrode system is adjustable for different head sizes. It is easy to clean, and it can be placed quickly and intuitively on the head of an infant. Now, we have designed our test to perform much faster. In fact, it is one of the fastest tests in the market today. So this brings me to my first point. We've made a product of the highest quality because we decided to embrace constraints, such as those that exist here. The second area that we're focused on is effective service delivery. What if a child screams positive? You know, what are the next steps? What is after that? So we're building an aftercare network of experts, region-wise, so that the children that screen positive can be referred to them. So they get intervention at the right time, which leads to better outcomes. What about awareness? You know, and not a lot of people, you don't need a lot of hearing impaired in India who can speak. So much so that a lot of people here don't know that the deaf can ever develop speech. So we are creating an awareness campaign to let people know ahead of time, to create pull from the customer side, to make them demand for screening when the child is born. And last, we're focusing on a self-sustaining value chain. So we believe that to really achieve impact, there are 26 million babies born in India each year, and even more in developing countries around the world. To be able to reach all of them, we have to have a sustainable business model. We want to create value for our customers, our users, and we believe that if they see value in it, they will screen more children. And with that, we can create even more impact. These are some of our partners who are giving us support and recognition. Among them are Grand Challenges Canada, Center for Innovation in Global Health, Stanford India Biodesign, and the latest, which was mentioned just now, the Rolex Award for Enterprise. So to give you a short idea of where we're at right now, we've tested the device on ourselves several times during the course of development. I have passed consistently. We have validated the test on an adult population, and we're going to start screening infants before the end of this year. In fact, this was one of the first infants that we put the device on, and we hope that we can reach millions more with your support. And we want to create sustained impact till no child, no matter where she's born, she or he is born, goes without timely intervention, so they can become independent and contributing members of our society. Thank you.